Hello students, welcome back to the online classes. In the last video, we read the first part of chapter 2, January night. Today, we will start with the second part. A dark January night, in the sky, even stars seem to be shivering. At the edge of his field, underneath a shelter of cane leaves, Halku lay on a bamboo cot, wrapped up in his old shawl, shivering. Underneath the cot, his friend Zebra the dog was whimpering with his muzzle pressed into his belly. Neither one of them was able to sleep. Halku curled up and said, "Cold, Zebra. Didn't I tell you in the house you could lie in the paddy straw? So why did you come out there? Now you will have to bear the cold. You thought I was coming out here to eat puris and sweets, and you came running on ahead of me. Now you can mourn all you want." So here in this paragraph we see it was night of January, and we know in the northern part of India, month of January is the coldest month. Halku had come to his field in that January night, where the stars were all shivering. He had made a small shelter at the edge of the field. He was lying down on a bamboo cot, covering himself with an old shawl. Below his cot, his dog also was sleeping and mourning. Halku commented on him that you should have stayed at home and could have lied on the paddy straw, so you could protect yourself from the cold. But you thought that I was coming here to eat good food. Now you can just shiver in this cold. Zebra wagged his tail without getting up, protected his whimpering into a long yawn, and was silent. Halku reached out his hand and patted Zebra's old back. "From tomorrow on, stop coming with me or the cold will get you. We will get through the night somehow. This is the reward you get for farming. While we do the hard work, somebody else gets the joy of it." Zebra looked at him with eyes overflowing with love. "You have to put up with just one more cold night. Tomorrow, I'll spread some straw. You won't feel the cold." Zebra put his paws on Halku's knees and brought his muzzles close. Halku felt his warm breath. So here in this paragraph, Zebra just looked at him. Out of compassion, and went back silently. Halku tapped his hand on Zebra's cold back and said, "Tomorrow onwards, you need not to come with me, or else you will catch cold. Somehow you manage to go through this night, and tomorrow I will spread some straw for you, so you will not feel cold. This is the reward we get for our hard working, that we suffer in the bitter cold and somebody else gets the joy of it. And Zebra put his legs on Halku's knees and slept there. Halku lay down. Like some kind of witch, the cold weather continued to torment him. When he could no longer bear it, he gently picked Zebra up and got him to fall asleep in his lap. The dog's body gave off some kind of stink, but Halku, hugging him tight, experienced a happiness he didn't felt for months. Zebra probably thought he was in heaven, and in Halku's innocent heart there was no resentment of him smell. He embraced him with the very same affection he would have felt for a brother. He was not crippled by poverty yet. Rather, it was as though this singular friendship had opened all the doors to his heart and brilliantly illuminated even atom of it, every atom of it. Suddenly, Zebra picked up the noise of some animal. Springing up, he ran out of the shelter and began to bark. Halku whistled and called him several times, but Zebra went on barking. Here, we could see that Halku could not get sleep because of the severe cold. So he got up, took Zebra in his arms and held him very close to his body so that the dog could sleep. In spite of the stinging smell of Zebra, could not break Halku's kind heart. Zebra thought himself that he was in heaven. Halku thought Zebra as his own brother, whom he was caring. It was like a friend and was helping his dearest and loving friend. Suddenly, Zebra heard some animal's noise and ran away from Halku's warm lap. Halku whistled and called him many times, but Zebra didn't turn back. So I stop here, dear children. Your homework is read the chapter carefully and write down the word meanings and learn it. Thank you.